Hi, I'm Brad.
And I'm John.
And we're Gen X Reacts, and what are we continuing on with?
Since you made me do an American one, I'm going to protest and not do something British. No. It is actually a protest song, oddly enough. By the Cranberries, and the song is Zombie.
So we go from fast car to zombie.
Yes, we go from fast car to zombie.
Because we need a fast car to get away from the zombies.
Sure, let's go with that.
Yeah, no, that's not at all what any of the songs are about, but, you know.
Yeah.
Sounded good at the time.
Yeah.
Anyway. So the Cranberry Zombies.
Mm-hmm. Which did hit number one in Australia, Belgium, Denmark, France, Germany, Iceland. The modern rock tracks chart in America. So it's also another one of those just kind of like iconic songs.
Yeah.
Partly, I think, because of the
leads.
I guess that too. I was actually going to say the lead singer's voice.
And we've seen it on quite a few, like just the other reaction videos that we've done.
Yeah. It's been on quite a few list videos.
Yeah.
I guess it placed number 18 on the US top 40. Hmm. And it hit 14 in the UK. The lead singer, it was written by the lead singer, Dolores O'Riordan. I think I got that right. Except without the Irish accent. I can do an Irish accent. It's very, very bad. My Australian one's better.
I know, half the people think you're from Australia when you talk.
Shut up.
Now, I don't even think you have an accent anymore, so...
You're used to me.
Huh?
You're used to me.
Yeah. Let me know if you think he has an accent, because I don't... hear it.
I got rid of most of it because I got tired of Americans going, huh?
It's weird because a friend of my mom's when we were growing up, she used to babysit occasionally. She was from England and she always had an accent. Her accent never went away.
Yeah. I kind of trained mine out though.
Yeah.
Purposefully because I got tired of people not understanding what I was saying.
Yeah. I don't know. Because I don't hear it.
Yeah.
You'll have to let me know if you hear it.
Not Irish, though. No.
I can't do an accent, period.
Okay, hitting the play button.
We'll be right back.
saying, my mum actually, when she was a teacher, this was late 90s, was actually working with a lady who used to be a police officer in Northern Ireland during a lot of the troubles. Can we really call them just troubles these days? I guess we can. The troubles between the British government and the Irish Republican Army, the IRA. But I mean, it was kind of like back then when the song came out, it was sort of, it was still like every other week something happened. You know, a bomb went off somewhere.
Yeah.
Or, you know, 50 people were found dead. You know, it's,
yeah, unfortunately, it still goes on. It's always gone on, and
yeah, it's. I want to say it's kind of like one of those things that sort of it's. You hear about these things on the news in America, but it's always kind of like far away.
Mm-hmm.
With, you know, with this, it's kind of like some of the actions took place in England themselves, but it's sort of like, yeah, still, it's kind of like, even so, it's sort of like, it's just, it's right there.
Yeah, I think unless our media,
the, you know, the distance involved is, well, I mean, England is tiny compared, yeah, to America.
Yeah.
But, you know, I mean, Ireland isn't Ireland, literally not that far away from England.
Yeah.
Kind of like, it takes no time at all just to get there. So it's kind of like, isn't it, is, it's not, oh, this is happening a world away. It's kind of like, this is, you know, this is basically just across the street.
Yeah, it's kind of like what we're having right now with the Ukraine.
Yeah.
Can't really say a lot of it because YouTube doesn't allow it, yeah, to be said. So, but yeah. And there again, we wouldn't really be knowing that was going on if it wasn't.
Yeah, if it wasn't for just, you know, the
media and some of the political stance, yeah, behind it. It's, you know.
Although it has seemed to have been forgotten a bit in the news recently. It's like it's still going on.
Yeah.
But it's probably not being reported anywhere near as much as it should be.
Yeah. But we're liable to have to put up a built-in thing on it anyway.
Hopefully not.
Yeah, we'll see what when we upload what YouTube says.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, and she's got such a great voice, and to use their platform to bring awareness to it, because we were just talking about,
yeah,
it. People don't realize what's going on unless,
yeah,
the media or people talk about it.
Yes, yeah, I mean, especially back then, because, yeah, it was one of those things. It's kind of like, I'm sure if it got mentioned, it was because there was some massive attack, on American news, but for the most part, it's kind of like,
well, it's
probably just sort of like, meh, it's,
it, I mean, it's amazing, it
never
that
gets a mention.
Crap stuff, whatever, is so it goes,
yeah,
on in today's world like that. I mean, it's like,
yeah,
you know, it's like we're not living back in the 1700s where, yeah, you fought,
yeah,
and stole each other land and stuff like that because you didn't live in a civilized society. Now it's like,
needless to say, I should point out that if you don't, you know, people don't realize the violence has actually stopped in Northern Ireland since the 90s, but it was late 90s, early 2000s, yeah, when the violence actually wound down. But
it's definitely a powerful song. Well, she has such a powerful voice too.
Yeah.
And a powerful video.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully we don't have to lock out the video.
Yeah.
But if we do, obviously the link to the original video is in the description.
Mm-hmm.
So go check it out. Because yeah, I mean, it definitely, sometimes unfortunately it takes,
yeah,
people with platforms to bring awareness to things, and that's definitely one of the...
Okay, so the conflict officially ended in Northern Ireland in 1998.
Yeah, and that just, I mean, amazes me, that stuff. And stuff still goes, I mean, you have stuff going on in the Middle East and stuff too. It's like just, I don't know. I guess you probably can't say too much about, you know.
Yeah. And the...
Yeah,
the lead singer. It's another good case of people passing away too early, because she passed away in 2018, aged 46.
Jeez. She's only 46. I didn't even know if she had passed away.
Yeah.
And 18, that was 5 years ago, too, so it's been, been a while, too. Yeah, it seems like all these great artists always seem to pass away way too young.
Yeah.
Whether they're musicians or actors or...
Well, this seems to be... It's almost like you have the two extremes. They either pass away incredibly young, or, you know, like the Rolling Stones, they're 387 million years old at this point, and still going.
Yeah. Or Betty White, you know, leaving to be... I think she died, like a day before her 100th birthday.
Yes.
And I think...
I mean, seriously, the Rolling Stones are actually doing concerts this year.
Yeah, they're doing it this year.
Yeah, they're doing some concerts this year.
Yeah,
seriously.
Well,
they're
hey, man, I guess if you could do it.
They're almost in their 90s.
Yeah, and I'm talking about I can do stuff and I'm only in my 50s.
Oh.
But when you do construction, you know, and
well,
it's kind of... But I don't know, They had to live the lifestyle they lived.
It's kind of like,
it's pretty amazing.
Still do it.
Yeah. So hey, well, that was is it the zombie? No, just zombie.
It's zombie Zombies and the Cranberries.
Yeah, by the Cranberries. So, well, we'll definitely probably check out more from them and you know, other bands like that. So, if you want to see it, make sure to hit the like and subscribe.
And the notification bell.
And until next time, thanks for watching.